Hi guys, welcome to our English talk show. Today we are very honored to have invited a very famous French writer and documentary director, Mr. Dion, to be on our show. Hi, Mr. Dion.
Hi.
Welcome to China, welcome to AllenTalk.
Thank you.
Yeah, how are you today?
I'm pretty good. That's my first time in China.
First time?
It's great to discover your city and your country.
When did you arrive here?
I arrived yesterday.
Yesterday.
And I had a great night. Uh-huh. Last night I went to a great restaurant, mm-hmm. then we went to a club to listen to rock and roll, and then I went to my hotel biking during the night.
Have you tried biking hutongs in Beijing?
Yeah. I like it. I'm actually biking a lot in Paris, so I'm used to use my bike in the city.
I see. And that's also, I think, biking is related to the documentary you made.
Absolutely.
Tomorrow, right? 2 or 3 years ago. I watched that documentary, very much impressed. And I highly recommend our audience to watch that.
Great.
Yeah, and in that documentary, you mentioned about, you know, protecting the environment, right? And biking is, bicycling, right, is one of the way to save energy. Mm. And in the very beginning, you gave us kind of like, for me, I personally felt there was a sense of urgency that we're on the edge of going extinct, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah. And then in the end, I'm very happy. You gave us hope.
That was the point. Yeah, to scare you and then to propose some solutions.
Exactly. Mm. And also in order to, you know, make the hope, make the good things to happen, mm-hmm. to prevent us from going extinct, we have to think globally and act locally, right? Mm-hmm, to give a helping hand. So as a director, can you tell us more about tips, how we can give a helping hand?
Actually, just to talk a few minutes about the problem, mm-hmm. we have two main problems now, ecologically. Mm-hmm. Global warming, the climate is just getting warmer and warmer, and that is going to provoke many, many problems mm-hmm. in the world. There is some part of the world where people will not be able to live anymore because it's going to be
too hot.
Too hot. Uh-huh. We're going to have a lot of storms, a lot of hurricanes, a lot of drought. So a problem with the water, problem with agriculture.
Yeah, we see this quite often in the news now.
Yeah. So that's a huge problem. Mm-hmm. We have another problem is the mass extinction of biodiversity. All the animals who are dying, mm-hmm. insects. Mm-hmm. In the last 40 years, we lost 50% of the vertebrates, animals on the
50%
planet. 50%, half of them.
Wow.
So that's huge.
Yeah.
In Europe, in the last 30 years, we lost 80% of flying insects.
80%?
80%.
Wow. How did that?
So we lost, because of the pesticides mainly.
Oh, I see.
We also lost 30% of the birds because birds are eating insects.
So if
insects
we
die,
destroy the birds ecosystem.
Are dying. Yeah. And all that is a chain. We are part of something where every species is interdependent with mm-hmm, mm-hmm. each other. So if too many species are dying, mm-hmm. we might die also.
As well. Mm-hmm.
So we need to do something about it. So we need to do everything we can to stop the climate from getting warmer. Mm-hmm. So as you mentioned, that's consuming less energy. Mm-hmm. So less energy in general, because mm-hmm. even when you are using electric bike or electric car, it's also causing harm to the environment because you have to dig. You have big mines in China, for example, where we have to dig some metals mm-hmm. and rare, I don't know the name in English, but anyhow, all the things you need to make smartphone work, to make electric batteries work. Mm-hmm. And doing that by digging, by making these huge mines, you are sending some gas in the environment, which is warming the climate.
I see. And also you're using the unusable resources. Right?
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So you need to consume less energy and to mm-hmm. try to use renewable energy and not that much mm-hmm. fossil fuels. So
I see.
If you can have solar panels at your home, if you can use your bike instead of using your car, mm-hmm. and it's going to be better for the air also, because there's a lot of pollution in the air because of the cars, mm-hmm. because of the coal and the coal factories.
Yes, yes.
So if you can use your bike, it's going to be better for your health, it's going to be cheaper, it's going to be better for the air and better for the environment and the climate. So really good thing to say.
Exactly.
It's a good thing to do. If you can eat less meat, less fish, that's going to be better also. Because to raise the cattle, to raise the cows, we need to grow some soy and some corn. And to do that, we have to cut the forest. And when you cut forests, for example, in Amazonia, to raise some soy and some corn to feed the cattle, you warm the climate. And you also remove of the planet something that is taking down all the carbon and storing it.
So this
so that's really bad. So we should eat less meat. Mm-hmm. I mean, one, twice a week, but not every day, not at every meal.
I guess that's something you practice every day now, right?
Actually, I've been a vegetarian for 3 years. Uh-huh. Now I'm starting to eat some meat and some fish again, a little bit, but I don't take dairies and I don't take eggs anymore because of food allergy.
Oh, I see.
So all the proteins, all the food that is coming from the animals, milk, eggs, meat, we should eat less and more vegetables, more fruits.
I see. Is that the time when you right before you shoot the documentary or during the shooting of the documentary you
actually
became vegetarian?
I became a vegetarian right after the movie was finished.
I see. And maybe you can tell us a bit more about that documentary. I know it has different chapters, right?
Yep.
Energy is one of them.
We have five chapters.
Yeah, what are they?
The point of the documentary was to show what the world could look like if we would use some of the best solutions we already know to change agriculture, energy, economy, democracy,
and education.
Absolutely. And to try to show that everything is linked. Mm-hmm. If you want to change agriculture, now we have a really modern agriculture that is really dependent on oil. We need oil to make fertilizer, to run all the tractors and all the machines. Mm-hmm. So if we want to change agriculture, we have to change our energy system. And if we want to change our energy system to move from fossil fuels to renewable energy, we need money. Yep. We need to finance that.
How you can make it sustainable.
So we need to change our economy. But to change our economy, we need political systems to create taxes, for example, taxes on carbon. Because if you have a great taxes on carbon, carbon is going to be expensive. Mm-hmm. So you will rather use renewable energy than fossil fuels. And to change politics, we need people to get involved. People to ask their leaders, okay, we want to do something better for the environment. So you need to change education. You need to educate people.
Wow, very good. Those five factors are really interconnected with each
other.
So with a joint force, we can really make a difference.
Yeah. And what we try to do is to show common people like you and me doing great things. Yeah. So that when you watch the movie, you can identify to them and say, okay, this guy just looks like me.
Yeah.
So what he does, I could do it too.
Exactly. Yeah,
and at the end of the movie, just go out of the theater, or if you are at home watching it on your TV, just feeling a lot of energy, a lot of creativity, and thinking, okay, I could also be part of this movement.
Exactly. I'm also it's also related to me. I can give a helping hand.
Yeah. Exactly.
I'm not just thinking globally.
I'm not just going to wait for someone to change things for me. I can do it too.
I see. Wonderful. Wow. You know, I'm sure shooting a movie must be really difficult. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Can you tell us, you know, during the shooting of a film, what's the most challenging thing you've ever experienced?
Actually, you have great challenges during the three main steps of making a movie. Because there is a really famous American director called William Friedkin who says, actually, you write your movie three times. When you write it, when you shoot it, and when you edit it.
I see.
And at the three stages, it's a lot of challenges. And there is a fourth challenge, which is finding money. Oh. Finding money to finance your movie. Mm-hmm. That was maybe the main challenge for this one, because nobody wanted to finance this movie. They were saying, okay, it's a documentary, you know, documentary, it's not making that much money, so we don't know. And that positive thing, like doing a movie really positive, we don't believe in it. People don't want to see positive things. And I was like, are you sure? Yeah, we're, you know, we're working in the movie business for so many years.
People like to watch tragedies,
exactly,
disasters.
Exactly. So you know what we had to do is to make a crowdfunding. We used a French platform called Kiss Kiss Bang Bang.
Okay.
And we asked people, okay, if you want that movie to exist, can you give us 5 euros, 10 euros, 20 euros, 50 euros, I don't know. And we wanted to raise 200,000 euros, which is a huge amount.
Yeah.
And we had 60 days to do it. It's a challenge. You have to do it in 60 days. And if you have like 100,050 euros at the end of it, you lose everything. It's all or nothing.
Yeah. I see how you work.
And actually we raised 200,000 euros in 3 days.
Only 3 days, wow.
And at the end of it, we raised 450,000 euros. So that was a huge signal for all the movie business that people wanted to see that movie. Mm-hmm. So many producers, TV channels came to us and said, well, that's a great project. Maybe we should be part of it.
Well, it's too late already. I already got the money from the crowdfunding.
And then the main challenge was to prepare the movie really well so that we could go only 2 or 3 days in each country or each city and really to get what we wanted. Mm-hmm. That was one of the greatest challenges. And then when we were at the editing, the greatest challenge was to link all that thing.
Yeah,
to be to use all these examples and characters to tell a great stories. And it was a long process. We edited for 9 months.
Wow. Mm. I can imagine how time consuming, how complex that was. You got must have footage of maybe how many hours
we
of
have
footage?
130 hours.
Oh my god. I can't imagine, but you really pulled it off very well in the end.
Well, we had a lot of chance because we had a great producer who, because we were supposed to edit for 5 months. Mm-hmm. And at the end of the fifth month, I was like, okay, it's not done. Mm. So we need more time. And we had really the greatest luck to have some people who could help us to buy more time.
I see. Very good. And also, I really enjoy the soundtracks of the movie.
Yeah.
Yeah, it really accentuate, you know, the meaning behind the movie.
We wanted the movie to be a pop movie.
Really?
To have some youngster, you know, in the theater. Because most of the time, when you watch a documentary about ecology, it's really boring. And it's really dull.
Yeah,
and
but this one's different.
And you feel so depressed at the end of it, you want to kill yourself. You know, it's like, okay, the world is over, so let's kill myself, let's jump over a bridge or something.
Yeah.
And I wanted the opposite thing. I wanted people to feel really enthusiastic, really happy at the end of the movie. So the soundtrack was really important.
Yeah.
And we had the great chance to work with a great Swedish and French artist called Fredrik Kastal, and she did a wonderful job.
Wow. Again, I highly recommend the soundtrack to all the audience.
Yeah.
Okay, I think the time is
up.
But maybe one last question. Yeah, you know, many our audience are youngsters. They also like to get into the movie business to shoot things that they like. Any advice you could give to them?
Actually, if you want to do a movie, just do something you love. I mean, you're good when you love the things you do, when you're passionate. So don't try to do a movie like anybody else. Just find something that is a really deep subject that you're really passionate about, that is really touching for you, and try to speak about it. Try to think about what you want to say to the world. What is the thing that is different from anybody else you want to express? Because there is so many movies.
Indeed.
There are many movies every year. So you need to be different.
Mm-hmm. You make a different movie, a different message to the audience.
You need to understand how specific you are.
Mm-hmm.
What is the really different thing you want to say to the world?
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you so much for taking the
interview.
And we are looking forward to seeing more wonderful movies from you.
And there is a book also.
Oh yes, you can tell them where they can get the access to the book.
Actually, in any bookshop or maybe on internet. And it's called also Demain, Tomorrow.
Tomorrow, okay. If you enjoy the movie and also you definitely enjoy the book. Yeah. Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you.
A été publiée il n'y a pas très longtemps une information qui annonce la fin possible de notre humanité.
Climate change, destruction of the Earth's surface and population growth are leading us to a tipping point.
Il y a 3 ans, Cyril est venu me parler de cette étude. Elle disait que mon fils grandirait dans un monde où l'eau, la nourriture, le pétrole viendraient à manquer dramatiquement.
Pendant 7 ans, j'ai dirigé une ONG. J'ai essayé par tous les moyens de montrer que nous devons changer nos façons de vivre. Mais les gens ne veulent plus qu'on leur dise que les choses vont mal. Tout va déjà trop mal. Alors nous avons décidé de tenter quelque chose de nouveau.
On est parti aux quatre coins de la planète pour trouver les femmes et les hommes qui proposent des solutions à tous ces problèmes.
We didn't start with, shall we save the planet? Because that was too grand. We just start with where we are.
Partout, des hommes et des femmes inventent un autre monde qui respecte la nature et les humains. D'autres façons de faire de l'agriculture, de l'économie, d'autres formes d'éducation, de démocratie.
Faisons tout à la main sur un tout petit territoire. On peut produire autant qu'avec un tracteur sur un territoire 10 fois plus grand.
San Francisco has an 80% landfill diversion rate. Everything is reduced, reused, recycled or composted.
Ces personnes écrivent une nouvelle histoire. Elles nous disent qu'il n'est pas trop tard, mais qu'il faut nous bouger. Maintenant.
Now we vote, we govern.
On voulait mettre toutes ces solutions bout à bout, comme un puzzle, pour tenter de raconter une nouvelle histoire et montrer à quoi notre monde pourrait ressembler demain.
In Totnes, we have a £21 note. Kind of
21.
Because you can. Why not?